Black woman decides to be a good Samaritan because she's a good person. She sees a credit card, returns it, tries to get it back to the owner, does the right thing, and ends up being arrested and her life turned upside down. This is out of Detroit. Let's put her picture up, full mask. Unbelievable story, but believe it. A Detroit good Samaritan tried to return the credit card to his rightful owner, but was arrested instead. On June 16th, the lady you're looking at, her name is Sandra Wilson. Miss Wilson walked to the gas station across from her home, as she has done many times before. While checking out her merchandise, her items, she noticed a credit card was left on the counter, tried to return it to its rightful owner. Surveillance still shows Miss Wilson in the blue dress. The woman with the long hair, the true owner, is seen leaving, but walks back in. Another woman with the pink pants steps away, and the card owner talks to the clerk and leaves her card on the counter out of the view of Miss Wilson. After the lady in the pink leaves, Miss Wilson notices the card and walks out to ask the woman in pink, "Hey, did you leave your card?" She replied, "Yes." Miss Wilson retrieves the card and gives it to her. Simple, right? Nope, there's more. Miss Wilson went on with her life, okay? She started receiving calls, however, from family members saying that she was wanted by the police. The Detroit Police Department, 7th Precinct to be exact. There's a post they put up saying, "Hey, this woman is wanted by us for credit card fraud." Look at that, they put the woman online. There it is. Miss Wilson went to the precinct trying to clear her name because she did nothing illegal. She believes the police may have just made a good faith mistake. These are decent people, let me go clear this up. But instead, she went there to clear it up. She was arrested, called a liar because she claimed she gave the card back to the clerk. The police did not provide the surveillance video for Miss Wilson to play out the scene for them, okay? Stills of Miss Wilson being interrogated. She said, and I quote, "I don't know what you all want me to tell y'all. I just walked in the gas station and you all took a picture of me and ruined my life." End quote. Miss Wilson asked for an attorney 3 times. Yet they continued to interrogate her. I got enough law school under my belt to know that is completely illegal. The officer seen here tells her, "I can tell you're lying. We know for a fact you're lying. We know." Miss Wilson fired back, "No, you don't know for a fact because I'm not lying." Miss Wilson spent 3 days in jail, faced 2 felonies that could have sent her to 4 years in prison. Reputation has been damaged, life upside down, felony charges still on her record. 4 months later, a judge looks at this case. Let's put him up. Judge Paul Chusick of Wayne County, 3rd District Court judge. He saw the video. He just looked at the damn video, that's all he did. He looked at the video and dismissed the case right before it went to trial. These SOBs were going to prosecute this woman, and all the judge had to do was hit play. Think about the lack of value a person has for another individual when they're not willing to just hit a button. I said, "Well, let me see, let me check it out. All right, okay, I don't believe you, but just in case, let me hit play." They didn't even do that for her. The judge did. "This is unbelievable to me," the judge says. "No trier of fact, even in the light most favorable to the prosecution, could ever think that Miss Wilson is guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. Absurd and ridiculous and wrong, and this was not a thorough investigation." End quote from the judge. Good for you, judge. Now, I need you to sanction the attorney who was going to bring this before you. Chief of Police James E. White and Commanding Officer John Sevick of the 7th District. Those are your leaders. They failed. Although Wilson's case was dismissed and charges were dropped, her image is still floating around online, labeling her as a credit card thief. She hasn't been able to find a new job and was evicted from her own apartment. They embarrassed me, humiliated me. I have 49 applications, I can't get a job. She said, that's not fair. And let me say this for everyone watching. Yes, the charges were dropped. But when there's a question that says, have you ever been charged or convicted of a felony? She has to say yes. But black people, in particular, when you say you have been charged with a felony, you might as well have been convicted. All right, Jessica, thoughts here.
Yeah, it's very clear these people have a predisposition to look for crime. And when you think about during the Halloween season, when they talk about drug dealers putting fentanyl in the candy and stuff, it's ridiculous because if you're a drug dealer, you're in that business to make money. We've talked about this on TYT before. If you are someone who is committing credit card theft, you're not gonna go into a store or go to a police station and try and return it. I mean, let's be very real. They're trying to frame people for crimes because they have a predisposition to look for crimes in the black community.
So well said, predisposition to look for crimes, and they have the innate bias that couples together that really victimizes people of color.